I'm here with the director of The Garden, Mr. Scott Hamilton Kennedy, and this film is so remarkable. It means so much to the community.
The scene has really gone crazy out here right now.
No justice, no peace!
We have not found a larger inner city garden anywhere in the U.S.
Middle of downtown, you have 13 acres of people growing food.
You know, it's a pretty simple idea. Land, people, food, happy days.
They want us out of the garden, just like that.
This is a very sad and tragic situation.
We wanted an explanation of how come she allowed this to happen. At that point, we didn't know that she was basically part of the deal, you know?
Jan Perry did a backroom deal.
Es una venta ilegal.
Something isn't right. It's just one of those things like, not this time.
Television show on PBS called Life and Times, a wonderful television show called Life and Times. And they had found out that the garden was going, that the farmers had gotten an eviction notice, and that it was an eviction notice from this amazing garden. I mean, it's the largest community garden in the country, over 14 acres, and it was born out of, as a healing, a form of healing from the 1992 riots related to the Rodney King verdict. And now they're being evicted, and there's a struggle, and there's questions of a backroom deal, and most of, the most important thing is the farmers aren't leaving. So there's a fight right there. And I visited the garden on a Tuesday and started shooting on a Wednesday. It was just a few weeks before their first eviction notice. And we just hit the ground running because it seemed like not just an important story, but a story with a very strong ticking clock.
With something like this so powerful and occurring in the Los Angeles scene, it's no surprise that people in Hollywood actually got involved with the project as well. Tell us a little bit about that.
Sure, a lot of, it was through different courses of the story that different stars, celebrities we call them, would come out and support. James Cromwell was one of the first ones to come out, and politicians as well, Dennis Kucinich, people like that. But, well, it's nice to see people, you know, kind of, you know, walk the walk and not just show up and say, I'm a star, let me, you know, take away my award or walk down the red carpet. They believed in these farmers' struggles, and they wanted to see the farmers get their rights heard, and they showed up and supported them. So as James Cromwell really put it in an interesting way, he said, I don't have any more unique idea about this situation. I'm not any more eloquent than any of these farmers to tell you why this is important. But I come here and I get the cameras, you know, I get the attention because of who I am. Mm-hmm. So if I can help them get their story out there, that's why I'm here.
Dan Perry, come on down!
I'm old now, but I have one little piece of hell to raise, and that's around these farmers.
I dare you! F*** with the gate!
They just want to say that they're staying on the land and that's it. Take no prisoners, negotiating stance.
What you have done here is an example of what should be done in cities all over the United States.
The time is up for the gardeners to be perceived as the community. They are not.
There's got to be something wrong with the city doing that.
Taking away our way of life.
But you really have to follow the money and connect the dots and see who actually caused the shots in that.
I thought it was remarkable that they were actually able to raise that $16 million in order to save the plot of land. How did they go about doing that? And the organization there was amazing as well. Tell us a little bit about that.
Sure. It was incredible in that short amount of time they raised the money. The largest chunk of it did come from the Annenberg Foundation. So we have to give a lot of respect for the fact that they did that. But they didn't give up. I mean, they never quit through the whole course of this story. They kept trying, and they, you know, had the concert to raise money, and they did blasts on e-blasts and got in, you know, community support, not just in Los Angeles but actually all around the world. People sent in money. But the main one was getting a huge organization like the Annenbergs to come in and see that this was worth saving. And it's just a shame that the Annenbergs couldn't have been part of the discussion early on when the land was sold to Mr. Horowitz for $5 million, and then maybe we never would have had this struggle because they would have outbid Mr. Horowitz and it would have been over. You all understand when you see the film. So, sorry.
As you were creating, as you were making the documentary film, did you have any idea as to how it would all end?
Oh my goodness, no, no, I didn't. I definitely did not know it would go on this long. I did not know there was going to be this many twists and turns. And you know, as a filmmaker, as a documentary filmmaker, especially you're taking a leap of faith in hoping that the subject you're telling is worth the time of you as a filmmaker, and then in the end, the audience that's watching it. So you hope that there are going to be twists and turns and great characters struggling with these twists and turns, and they gave me that over and over and over again. The struggle was capturing all of it, which was wonderful and exhausting, and then piecing it together in a way that was coherent and hopefully entertaining in the editing room. And it took a long time. It was, I won't lie to you, it was a lot of hard work, but we're pretty happy with the result.
Understand, there's money involved in this.
The last thing I think anybody wants to see is bulldozers going in there, evicting people and, you know, plowing over their gardens. Is it gonna come to that? Oh, I certainly hope not.
Hay una parte en nuestro saludo a la bandera que dice, justice for all. ¿Dónde está la justicia para nosotros?
It was made clear to me that there was definitely a backroom deal here. Some people can look at this story and on the surface say, well, it's this gentleman's property and these farmers are lucky to be there and they should give him his land back. But that's the soundbite that too many news organizations covered, where it was much more complicated than that. The land was given to these farmers, and even if it was on a temporary basis, as a form of healing. Is that form of healing over? And why weren't the farmers told about the land being sold to Mr. Horowitz and give them an opportunity to buy it as well? That's fine. If the city says that we can't afford to have a community garden there, that's a sad thing. But if they're upfront about it and the farmers have a chance to raise the same amount of money as Mr. Horowitz, then great. But they didn't. They did things behind the backs of the farmers. And I don't even think sometimes out of being really sneaky, I think it was kind of lazy, really. They just wanted it to go away quickly, and they didn't realize that, you know, the farmers wanted questions answered, as any of us do. I mean, that's the American way. It's supposed to be justice for all, right? We hope.
It was a few times that word justice came up as an overall theme of the film. How do you think that played out in the end?
That's a tough question. I keep asking myself, you know, is justice for all a pipe dream, or is it really one of the founding things that we would, you know, die for as Americans, as, you know, as citizens of the United States? And I mean, it depends on the day. I'm very happy. I'm one of the people that's very happy to be seeing this current president going bye-bye, and very excited to see our new incoming president, Mr. Obama. And hopefully I really believe that he believes in that statement. I mean, he's an example of that statement. And so I have a lot of hope. That word has been thrown around a lot, but I have a lot of hope, so we'll see. He's got a lot on his plate.
Inside TV.
Check us out on the web.